This world is more and more flagrant with its sin. And we are dishonest if we were to say that there is not a measure wherein our flesh struggles with temptation to partake. It's hard to forsake the present in light of the future. It's always been hard. It's hard in human terms, much less in spiritual realities. Maybe the struggles you have with this world, maybe your desire is not sexual perversity, but rather vengeance. Maybe you live angry. Maybe it's not anger, but greed. Maybe the things of this world have gripped you, and you just want to hang on to it. Maybe it's not greed, but self-righteousness. There is a part of you that thinks continually, I'm so glad I'm me and not them. Listen, if there is a desire of the flesh, I will tell you with absolute certainty, there is a voice in the world saying, go ahead and partake. Whatever crosses your thoughts, whatever crosses your heart, there is a voice in the world crying out and saying, just go ahead. Now, our text this morning is Jesus continuing to exhort his disciples that they must. It's not negotiable. It's not, well, you really should try your best. They must live lives of readiness for his return. Amen. Now the world says, why bother? Right? And that's what all of 2 Peter 3 is addressing. It's saying, look, the world's going to send mockers. They're going to say, this has never changed. We've extended it. Now we live in a time where they don't just say thousands of years. They say it's been 100 million years, or one might say a billion, or the next one might say 200 million. It just depends. It's arbitrary. But what they're saying is, this is what it is. And it's up to us to take charge and control of it, because God's not going to. God's not real. God's not something that we look to. Listen, the world says, why bother living this way? Why would you forsake the desires of your heart? My goodness, is that not prevalent? I've said this before, but every high school graduation I've ever been to, and Lord knows in student ministry I've been to more than a few, that wasn't at this school or a like-minded Christian school, every one of them, the speaker inevitably said to the graduating class, you need to trust your heart. You need to follow your heart. Get out there and live for yourself. That's what's being pressed upon from the youngest of age, that this is the most important thing. You. We have a self-esteem issue. Yeah, the issue is, unbiblically, we esteem self way too much. The scripture speaks to the opposite, to the contradiction of that. That we're to live lives that, basically, to summarize how it is that we see Christianity, is that we are those who give up this so that we can have that. And in so doing, he gives us this to the fullest extent through grace and peace and the mercy that we get to experience. That's it. Now, we get to experience this world. Certainly, we live in this world. We must, therefore, live in some means in accordance to this world. However, any man who becomes gripped by this world is a man who loses the peace and the mercy and the grace that has been promised them in Christ.